recording. And now people would be feeling a little bit uncomfortable. So now we are into the recording now. Sharing my screen. The screen sharing has been started. We are right now into the valuation of the bond. And let me take one more example of the valuation of the bond, which we are going to go through from the material which I have already given to you. So everyone, try to read the question number 15. I guess you all are able to read it out. In case if you are not, just let me know so I can zoom it up a bit. Okay, I think now it should be visible to everyone. 100 par value bond bears a coupon rate of 12%. So 12% is the interest that we get on that particular bond and matures after 6 years. Interest is payable semi-annually. So here in this case, my dear students, the compounding, or we can call it a discounting in case of a PV, would be applicable on 6 monthly basis. Compute the value of the bond. If the required rate of return is 16% compounded semi-annually, what shall be the price of the bond which you should pay right now if your required rate of return from this bond is 16%? First of all, let me tell you, this is very unpractical example. No bond can give you 16% of a requirement. So whomsoever who has set these expectations are sky high. There is absolutely no rational, no logic behind setting this kind of an expectations from the bond. Agar bond aapko 16% return de deta, to equity wale buddhu ho gaye hain ki itna risk leke wahan pe jaye. To ye unrealistic expectations hai, lekin fir bhi hum is question ko theoretically solve karne wale hain. So first of all, let me write the details. Everyone would be writing that in your notebook. What is the par value of the bond? Get, my dear students, will always be on the par value, that you everyone should be aware about that. What is the interest rate? Coupon rate is 12%. Writing that again so that we'll be able to solve it. Six monthly is the compounding frequency. Compounding frequency 6 months. What is the number of years of the bond? Sir, it is going to be matured after 6 years. You are getting too much overexcited. We are already in the festive joy right now. You are spoiling the festive joy by going into the technical matters of the subject. But I am bound to do my duty. Compute the value of bond if required rate of return is 16%. Your required rate of return is 16%. Now, two things you will have to apply. You are going to get the return, that is the interest, and that interest you are going to get for 12 periods. Sir, how did you get that 12 periods? Because you are going to invest in this bond for 6 years, and in 1 year you have 2 6-month. So actually, the interest you are going to receive will be for 12 periods. Okay, sir, we have got it. Some of you might be seeing that, might be able to notice that various other things that we are going in the financial mathematics have already been covered into various other subjects. But my task right now is to go into fundamentally as well as practically by using some Excel functions. So that we are coming. I think this lecture as well as the next lecture would be the last lecture as far as the theoretical part. Theoretical in terms of going through the books kind of an example would be the last lectures for you. As far as the first module is concerned, and at least 2 to 3 lectures I'm going to spend only for the Excel aspect of it, where you will be actually going through the practical questions again by using the Excel functions. Okay, so that would be the 12 periods. Understood, sir. Now you will have to tell me, my dear students, what we can do, how we value this bond. What we can do? I need the answer from all of you. This bond can be divided into two parts. We want to find the present value of cash inflow from this entire bond. Now, the present value of cash inflow from the bond can be divided into two parts. One is the interest, which is an annuity. Sir, why it is an annuity? Because my dear students, interest is you are going to receive. You are going to receive this interest at every 6 months. So that's why it's an annuity. And one would be the principal amount, which will be back. And principal amount can be called as a maturity amount as well. Maturity amount, in case if no information is given to you, would be the par value. If maturity is happening at the premium, then it would have been given to you that maturity will happen at 10% or 12% of premium. But in this case, we are assuming that it would be par value. And interest amount. What will be the interest amount? Can someone tell me? What is the interest you get on 100 rupees bond? My question is to all the students. Please unmute yourself and let me know. 12% is per annum. You are going to get on 6 month basis. So what will be the interest amount that you are going to get? Anyone?
6 rupees.
Absolutely correct. So it would be 6 rupees. 6 rupees you are going to get for how many number of periods? 12 periods. So this one would be the present value of annuity. And this one would be the present value of single transaction. Because maturity amount you get only for the one point of time, no? कोई इतना बुद्धू तो नहीं है आपको हर बार रोज रोज मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट दे दे, ला जा ले ला मोच कर मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट पहले साल में, जा यस मोच कर मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट दूसरे साल में, उड़ जाएंगे भैया. मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट यू रिसीव ओनली व्हेन द पीरियड ऑफ द बॉन्ड विल बी ओवर, व्हेन द बॉन्ड विल बी रिडीम्ड फ्रॉम यू. सो दैट वुड बी सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन. ओके, कैन समवन टेल मी व्हाट विल बी द फॉर्मूला ऑफ प्रेजेंट वैल्यू, एंड इफ यू टोटल दिस टू, नो, देन यू गेट द पीवीसीआई फ्रॉम द bond. Now here, while applying the rate of return, you will have to take the rate of return requirement from your side. Do not take the interest rate, otherwise you will end up getting the PVCI at 100 only. Do not take the interest rate, my dear students. Please ensure that you will have to take the required rate of return from the bond. Required rate of return from the bond is how much? 16%. So that rate will be used to do the calculation. What is the PV of annuity? Okay, in case of no information is given to us, which annuity we assume? Can someone tell me? Ordinary or annuity due?
Ordinary.
Very true. Ordinary. So what is the formula of ordinary? I in bracket 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus r raised to n divided by r. Yes or no? Okay. So let's solve this now. I would be the amount of interest. Amount of interest you are going to get. What will be the amount of interest we are going to use? 6. Do not take it 12. Here we want the interest per period. This is the interest per period. Installment per period. Installment per period would be 6. Though 12% is the rate of is the coupon rate for the entire year, but per period interest you are going to get would be 6 only. In bracket 1 minus 1 divided by 1 plus r. What r you will take? Required rate of return for the entire year is 16%. So your r would be how much? How much? 8%. Bachas are not replying to me. I don't know why. So 1.08 raised to n. What will be the n? For how many number of periods you are going to receive the interest? Who will tell me?
12.
Absolutely correct. That is to be divided by 0.08. Again, why we have taken 8 instead of 16? Because the compounding is happening on 6 monthly basis. No need to repeat it again and again. Sir, you are repeating it. हमने कहाँ पे बोला था? आप ही बोलते हो और फिर आप ही हमें criticize करते हो. तो कोई बात नहीं, भूल हो गई. ठीक है. Equal to 6 in bracket 1 minus. Now, how can you solve this? In calculator, do it 1 divided by 1.08. Press equal to. So, one time equal to will be pressed. Again, you are pressing the equal to 2 times. Accordingly, you are going to press the equal to for 12 times. So that you get this discounting factor. 1 divided by 1.08, press equal to. So, one time you have pressed it. Again, you will have to press it for 11 more times. Press it for 11 more times. For a better calculation, let me do it over here in the Excel as well. Equal to 1 divided by 1.08 raised to 12. So everyone should be able to get 0.3971. 0.3971 to be divided by 0.08. Moving further, equal to 6. Simplifying the denominator, so you will have to reduce it from 1. So equal to 1 minus this value. So we reaches to 0.6028 to be divided by 0.08. So equal to 6. As per the Bodemus theorem, the division needs to be taken first and then multiplication will happen. So this value has to be divided by 0.08. So you get 7.5360. And if you multiply that by 6, you get 45.21. Is everyone getting the same answer? In case of a difference, you may let me know. Just give me the confirmation if you have done with that. How to stop this Instagram notifications? I don't know. Okay. Oh yeah, Instagram so ऐसे फालतू के notifications है. कोई live video कर रहा है तो भी मुझे notification आता है यार. इसको कोई बंद करना सिखाएगा मुझे? कैसे करते हैं? अभी उसने लाइव वीडियो में क्या किया मुझे क्या मालूम वो क्या कर रहा है? मेरे को नहीं जानना है. PV of single transaction. So what was the formula of PV of single transaction? Can someone tell me? FV multiplied by 1 divided by 1 plus R raised to N. अच्छा कोई बताओ ना मुझे notifications कैसे बंद करते हैं? कि नहीं मालूम? जाने दो बच्चे सर, not responding तो मैं क्यों खाली फोकट का ये करूं? FV is the principal value you are going to get after 6 years. What is the value you are going to get? 100. In case of a no information given to you, you are assuming that par value will be the maturity value. So par value is 100 multiplied by 1 divided by 1.08. Again, why I have taken 8? Because interest payment is going to be, and compounding as well is going to be on 6 monthly basis. So raised to would be 12. I hope everyone is very much clear. 100 multiplied by. So here we are supposed to find raised to 12. So raised to 12 wala we have already got, I guess. Raised to 12 wala we have already got. I guess this one. 1 divided by 1.08 raised to 12. So this discounting factor we have already got. 0.3971. And if you multiply that with 100, so that comes around 39.71. लेकिन यहां पे हमारी कहानी खत्म होती है कि कहानी अभी भी अधूरी है? हमारी अधूरी कहानी PVCI would be 45.21 plus 39.71. So what is the value coming for the bond? Who will tell me? Waiting for your answers, tell me.
Sir.
Now rate of return is 16% from this bond. You should invest maximum 84.92 rupees in the bond. You should not invest any penny more than that. And if the market price of this bond right now is say 86, you will straight away reject this bond, because your required rate of return is getting satisfied. If this particular bond is available in the market right now at 82, has been traded at the trading platforms at 82 rupees, you will straight away say yes, proposal accepted. 82 rupees is a good deal. My required rate of return is getting satisfied. I should invest. So that is how we are going to interpret the value of the bond. So I hope the value of the bond is very, very much clear to all of you now. Now I am moving to another concept, and that is YTM, yield to bond. Say if I give you one detail, that market price of the bond is right now 85, maturity price of the bond will be 110, that is 10% premium. Par value is 100. Coupon rate is 9%, and bond will be having the lifetime of 8 years. Now you will tell me, that how we'll be able to find the rate of return which we are actually getting from this bond. What is the yield we are able to generate from this bond? So required rate of return hume find karna hai. So that means what will be the actual yield you will be generating from this bond. So here in this case, required rate of return is not given to you. So earlier we were having the required rate of return here. 16% was straight away given to you here. That's why you were able to find 8%. And that's why you were able to apply the discounting or compounding, whatever it may be in the question. But here in this case, you will not be able to apply the discounting because the rate itself is not given to you. So here in this case, my dear students, you cannot have the discounting rate itself. And if you do not have discounting rate itself, then what you will be doing? You are supposed to find the discounting rate only. So in the corporate finance, you might have studied the concept of IRR, internal rate of return. And in case of an internal rate of return, my dear students, you are using one formula. That was the interpolation formula, where you are finding the rate of return from the project. If you can recall it a bit. Instead of project, here in this case, we have the bond. At that point of time, you are investing in the project. Here you are investing not in the project, but you are investing in the bond. So the same IRR formula, the interpolation formula will be applicable over here in case when rate of return is not given to you. From this detail, you are supposed to find what is the yield to maturity for you. And that yield is not just the interest rate, my dear students. Try to understand, you are getting the two benefits. Number one benefit as a yield, as a return you are getting is the interest rate. Number two benefit is you are investing right now just at 85, but you are going to get 110. So you are getting the capital gain as well. Then capital gain is 110 minus 85. So that would be 25 rupees. And this 25 rupees you are going to get over a period of 8 years. So what is the annual rate of return you have generated from this 25? If you do the total of this, no, this is your effective yield, or that can be called as required rate of return. आपने तो आपका नाम लिख दिया, RR. इट कैन बी कॉल्ड एज रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न एज वेल. सेम IRR फॉर्मूला यू कैन यूज इट. नाउ व्हाट वाज दैट IRR फॉर्मूला? वी आर यूजिंग इट फॉर YTM. इन दिस केस देयर आर टू मेथड्स ऑफ सॉल्विंग दिस क्वेश्चन. वन इज द IRR मेथड, another one is the approximation method. In approximation method, I am coming in the next lecture, because that would be a shortcut way, and the name itself suggests it's an approximation. So it will not be able to give you the exact percentage of return. It will give you a near about return. So we'll come to that after some time. Right now you can go with the YTM, yield to maturity. Now yield to maturity, if you can recall it a bit, there was a R1 plus NPV at 1, means NPV at R1, that was divided by NPV at R1 minus NPV at R2, that was multiplied by R2 minus R1. If you can recall the formula a bit. Yaad aaya kuch corporate finance mein IRR wala formula? Anyone, everyone? आ रहा है कुछ याद? यस और नो?
यस सर.
कि सर ऐसा तो हमने कुछ किया ही नहीं था. किया था कि नहीं किया था भैया? किया था कि नहीं किया था?
यस सर.
अच्छा,
यस सर.
ओके. एनपीवी का मतलब क्या होता है? पीवीसीआई माइनस पीवीसीओ. सो दैट इज द नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू. Right now, R1 we do not have. It is more about applying the try and error method. You come up with 1% of a R and you try to know that whether PVCI minus PVCO is becoming equal or not. So, in this case, what is your requirement? You know, is that you want to make the PVCI equal to PVCO, and how you will be able to make PVCI equal to PVCO. So we will have to assume some rate. And at that particular rate, PVCI will become equal to PVCO. So that would be the yield to bond for you. Now, how we'll be able to get it? One rate we'll have to assume. So assume R1 at 10%. Now, some of the students would be like, sir, 10% kyun? Hame 15 karna ho to karo, mujhe koi problem nahi hai. कोई भी प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. 15 करो, 17 करो, 20 करो, लेकिन बहुत ज्यादा करोगे तो फिर नीचे वाला इंटरेस्ट आएगा, तो फिर आपको रेट्स बदलने पड़ेंगे. तो एक सेम पेपर पे रहता है, हर कोई मिस्टेक ना करे ना, इसलिए फिर यश 15% लेगा, फिर वो क्रीमी 12% लेगी, इशिता वगैरह कोई और 14% पे जाएगा, लीला वगैरह कोई और परसेंटेज लेगी. तो उससे अच्छा है कि पहला वाला हम एक कॉमन पेपर पे रहते हैं कि 10 लेते हैं, और कोई ऐसा रूल नहीं है. 12 भी ले सकते हो, 15 भी ले सकते हो, 25 भी ले सकते हो, कोई रूल नहीं. इट्स अ ट्राई एंड एरर मेथड. ओके, सो एट 10% यू विल हैव टू फाइंड द एनपीवी. दैट वुड बी स्टेप नंबर वन. फाइंड एनपीवी. व्हाट डू वी अंडरस्टैंड बाय एनपीवी? पीवीसीआई माइनस पीवीसीओ एट 10%. ओके, so at 10% you will have to find the NPV. पीवीसीओ तो मालूम ही है, पीवीसीओ कितना है, कितना मार्केट प्राइस है, 85, इतना ही आप इन्वेस्ट करने वाले हो। पीवीसीआई आपको फाइंड करना है तो आपको एनपीवी मिलेगा, ठीक है। पीवीसीआई को आप दो हिस्से में बांट सकते हो, पहला है वो है इंटरेस्ट और दूसरा है वो मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट। आपका जो इंटरेस्ट है उसके ऊपर आपका प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ एन्यूटी लगेगा, और आपका जो अमाउंट है उसके ऊपर आपका प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन लगेगा। एवरीवन डू इट एंड लेट मी नो व्हाट इज द पीवीसीआई कमिंग फॉर दिस एट 10%। यू विल बी अज्यूमिंग द रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न एट 10%। सो लेट मी सॉल्व दिस फॉर माई बच्चाज एंड बच्चीज, बिकॉज आई नो दैट दे विल नॉट बी सॉल्विंग। इंटरेस्ट वुड बी, वॉट इज द इंटरेस्ट रेट गिवन टू अस इन द क्वेश्चन, कूपन रेट 9%, ईयरली 9%। इंटरेस्ट रेट इज ऑलवेज ऑन द पार वैल्यू, पुट इट इन बैक ऑफ द माइंड, डू नॉट फॉरगेट इट, इंटरेस्ट विल ऑलवेज बी ऑन द पार वैल्यू। सो 9 रुपीज इज द इंटरेस्ट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट। सो पीवी ऑफ एन्यूटी वुड बी आई इन ब्रेकेट 1 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाई 1 प्लस आर रेस टू एन डिवाइडेड बाई आर। इंटरेस्ट रेट यू गेट वुड बी 9 इन ब्रेकेट 1 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाई 1.10 रेस टू, वॉट विल बी द नंबर ऑफ पीरियड, हु विल टेल मी वॉट विल बी द नंबर ऑफ पीरियड?
8 सर।
ओके, 8 इज द राइट आंसर और आप जीत जाते हैं कुछ भी नहीं, डिवाइडेड बाय 0.10। सो 9 इन ब्रेकेट 1 माइनस, सिंप्लीफाई दिस, आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्टेटेड टू यू दैट हाउ यू कैन सिंप्लीफाई दिस बाय यूजिंग द कैलकुलेटर। 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.10, कीप प्रेसिंग इक्वल टू फॉर 7 मोर टाइम्स, बिकॉज 1 टाइम यू हैव ऑलरेडी प्रेस्ड। And whatever the answer is coming, let me know. So equal to 1 divided by 1.10 raised to 8. So that comes around 0.4665. That is to be divided by 0.10. So you get 9. Let us reduce it from 1 now again. So it would be 1 minus 0.4665, press equal to, so you get 0.5335. Why I have taken 5 instead of 4? Because after that the immediate digit we have, no, that is 9. So that's why we have rounded it up 0.10. 9. Let's divide this value by 0.10. So this value divided by 0.10. मैं ही कर रहा हूं सब कुछ, बच्चों की तरफ से बिल्कुल नो रिस्पॉन्स। 5.3349, दैट इज टू बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 9, सो इक्वल टू दिस वैल्यू मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 9। So you get 9 multiplied by 48.01. Oh no, 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 no. This is itself a 48.01. Sir, so gaye 48.01. Question hamara khatam nahi hota hai. Yahan pe maturity amount, single value, single transaction hai. Usko bhi to bhool nahi jana hai. नामे बिचारे का सिंगल है, उसको भूल जाओगे तो और डिप्रेशन में चले जाएगा। सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन का पीवी फाइंड करते हैं। पीवी इक्वल टू एफ वी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1 प्लस आर रेस टू एन। व्हाट इज द मैच्योरिटी वैल्यू यू गेट? 100 110 की 100
110।
अरे वाह अरे वाह, 110 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.10 raised to n, n would be 8. So 110 multiplied by this discounting factor that we have already got, 0.4665. If you multiply that by 110, what is the answer you're getting, my dear students? Let me know.
51.31.
So, हमें total PVCI find करना है और total PVCI find करना है, तो ये दोनों का total करना पड़ेगा. So, दोनों का total कैसे करते हैं? PVCI equal to 48.01 plus 51.31. जानी, calculator में calculate करके मुझे बताओ क्या answer आता है? आपके रिस्पॉन्स का उत्सुक हूं मैं. 99.32. Now, we do not want 99.32 because our investment is going to be 85 rupees. We want that PVCI to become equal to 85 rupees, then only we will be able to find the rate of return requirement at 85. IRR का मतलब ये होता है कि इस रेट के ऊपर PVCI becomes equals to PVCO. At that particular rate, the PVCI is becoming equal to PVCO, but we are still far away to make it equal to 85. We are just right now at 99. If we want to reduce it further and we want 85, can someone tell me what we'll have to do? Whether we'll have to increase the rate or whether we'll have to decrease the rate? Who will tell me?
Increase, sir.
Absolutely correct. You increase the discounting rate, PVCI will be lower. If you want lower PVCI, no, you will have to increase the rate. Ab yahan pe problem mein hai. सर 15% करे, 20 करे, 25 करे कि 30 करे, तो जितना R1 और R2 ये दोनों के बीच में फर्क जितना कम होगा ना, उतना आंसर ज्यादा एक्यूरेट होगा. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे 15% में नहीं करूंगा क्योंकि मुझे मालूम है कि 15% में भी आंसर नहीं आएगा, तो हमें फिर से सॉल्व करना पड़ेगा. लेट्स टेक 20% PVCI एट 20%. Okay, so in this case, what is the NPV coming? NPV coming at 99.32 minus 85 is the PVCO. So NPV, can someone tell me what is the NPV at R1? Sorry, simple to calculation hai. Aap hi kar lo na, hame kyun puch rahe ho? To nahi puchna hai, theek hai? Ya to mere ko laga ki bachcho ko thoda sa involve karu, lekin bachche involve lene ka naam nahi le rahe hain. अब 20% पे सॉल्यूशन करो. चलो सब, एवरीवन स्टार्ट डूइंग इट एट 20%. डू द सेम कैलकुलेशन एट 20%, ऑल ऑफ यू, ऑल ऑफ यू. चलो भैया जल्दी मुझे बताओ क्या आ रहा है PVCO 20%. PVCO तो मालूम ही है, 85 रुपीस सर हमें इन्वेस्ट करना है. इसके दो पार्ट, एक इंटरेस्ट, एक है प्रिंसिपल अमाउंट, और वी कैन कॉल इट अ मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट. इंटरेस्ट में एन्यूटी का फॉर्मूला, मैच्योरिटी में सिंगल ट्रांजेक्शन का फॉर्मूला. और बताओ जल्दी से, और रिक्वायर्ड रेट ऑफ रिटर्न कितना लोगे? 20% लेंगे सर, बार बार बताने की जरूरत नहीं है. आपको इंटरेस्ट कितना मिलता है? 9 इन ब्रैकेट 1 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.20, हाँ 1.10 नहीं 1.20 रेस टू 8 डिवाइडेड बाय 0.20, और पीवी ऑफ मैच्योरिटी अमाउंट वुड बी 110 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 1.20 रेस टू 8. सॉल्व दिस एंड डू द टोटल ऑफ दिस. लेट मी नो द आंसर ऑफ दिस एवरीवन. डू इट एंड लेट मी नो.
34.533.
एंड व्हाट इज द आंसर कमिंग फॉर दिस वन? चलो ये दोनों का टोटल करते हैं तो हमें पीवीसीआई मिल जाता है भैया. सर टोटल हमें करके बताओ. 34.533 प्लस 25.59, सो पीवीसीआई का टोटल वुड कम एट 63.92. yes or no? तो सर ये तो उल्टा हो गया. हमें तो 85 चाहिए था, ये तो 85 के नीचे चला गया. तो अब यहां पे ध्यान में रखना कि IRR का फॉर्मूला कब यूज कर सकते हैं. When at 1 hour you should have the NPV positive. And at 1 hour, you should have the NPV negative. If these two conditions are satisfied, then IRR can be found. Yes, beta?
Sir, addition is wrong. 60.123.
Addition is wrong. Okay, 60.123. So what is the NPV coming? PVCI is how much? 60.123 minus 85 is the PVCO. So what is the NPV coming in minus? Tell me. All of you do it.
Minus 24.87.
24.87. Okay, at 1 hour the NPV shall be positive, at another hour NPV shall be negative. Okay, so that both the criteria has been satisfied. At one point of time we got the NPV of positive, and in a second time we got the NPV which is negative. Now lesser the difference between these two rates, no, more accurate the answer would be. But here the distance is too much, 10 and 20, so we'll not be able to get the exact accurate answer. It would be near about actually. So let's find the IRR, or we can call it in this case YTM equal to R1 is 0.10. Do not write it in percentage, otherwise you will get confused. Put it in decimals only right now. Plus, what was the formula? Check it out again. Here I had said, where is the formula gone? Where is the formula? Where is the formula? बच्चों को मुझे वापस दिखाना पड़ेगा ना फॉर्मूला, वरना फिर भूल जाएंगे. यस, हियर वी हैव द फॉर्मूला. आर वन प्लस एनपीवी एट आर वन डिवाइडेड बाय एनपीवी एट आर वन माइनस एनपीवी एट आर टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय आर टू माइनस आर वन. ओके, सो एनपीवी एट आर वन वी रिक्वायर. एक्सेल को बुखार आ गया है सर, इतना ज्यादा लोड दोगे आप एक्सेल को तो फिर बुखार आएगा ही आएगा. ओके, एनपीवी एट आर वन, व्हाट डू वी हैव इट? आर वन का एनपीवी क्या था? 14.5. Excel is getting stuck. 3-2, good. Here we have 14.32 R1 minus R1 minus R2 is the denominator, right? So minus would be, you have got NPV at R2, which is 24.87, but that is in minus. So minus 24.87. That is to be multiplied by R2 minus R1. R2 is 0.0 minus R1 is 0.10. Okay, so 0.10 plus 14.32 to be divided by this. Minus minus kya ho jayega? प्लस तो सर ये दोनों का टोटल करके बताओ मुझे जल्दी से सर आप तो बेसिक बेसिक मैथमेटिकल चीजें भी हमें बताते हो तो बताओ ना क्यों ना बताओ मेरी मर्जी 14.32 प्लस 24.87 सो यू गेट 39.19 ओवर देयर एंड हियर यू simplify this further so you get 0.10 so 0.10 equal to plus first you will do the division and then you will do the multiplication 14.32 divided by 39.19 so you get 0.3654 multiplied by 0.10 So multiplied by 0.10, you get 0.0365. And if you add it over there in 0.10, so you get 0.1365. And now if you put this into a percentage, so YTM in percentage would be, you will have to multiply this by 100. So you get 13.65%. So that is the required rate of return from this bond. If the market price is 85, if the maturity amount would be 110, and if the interest you are going to get for 8 years would be 9 rupees per annum. So effectively it would be 9% coupon rate on the par value. So in those kind of details, your required rate of return is coming out at 13.65%. So here you will have to apply your return expectations. If your return expectations is 15%, then you will straight away say no to this bond. But if your return expectations is coming at 5% or 7%, or 8%, you will straight away say yes for this bond because your expectations is satisfied. Are you all clear about this? All of you, my dear students? Anyone, any query, any doubt? Else I am signing off this session. YTM ke aur ek do sum karenge aur phir YTM ko kalti kar denge. Everyone, give me the confirmation, guys. All of you. Are you all getting it, all of you? Vidya, Krimi, Bhavya,
all yes, sir. It?
Good, thank you very much. It's good to see a profile picture for every students. Good. Kisi ne inform kiya tha ya? Aisa hi apne aap sabne laga diya. Sharing my attendance screen, na? Just give me a 30 seconds more. Going to share my attendance file to all of you.
Sir, from Instagram setting, you can change the notification.
यस क्रिमी कहाँ क्या थी था बेटा
इंस्टाग्राम सेटिंग नोटिफिकेशन
ઇન્સ્ટાગ્રામ સેટિંગમાંથી બંધ થઈ જાય ને,
પુશ
હા
પુશ નોટિફિકેશન.
નોટિફિકેશન માં લાઈવ અને આઈજીટીવી આવશે, એમાં ઓફ કરશો ને એટલે થઈ જશે.
હા એટલે ચાલો હું કરી નાખીશ. અમુક વાર છોકરાઓમાં લેક્ચર લેતા હોય ને, મને નોટિફિકેશન આવે, બધા નોટિફિકેશન દેખાય, બોલો કેવું ખરાબ લાગે.
સર વો આપ ઉપર સે ભી કર સકતે હો.
इधर मैं ये वाला डेस्कटॉप वाला नोटिफिकेशन है उसको मुझे डिसेबल कर देना, पता नहीं मैंने कभी तो एनेबल कर दिया था, कुछ आया था तो. BBAFM लेट मी अलाउ द रिस्पॉन्सेस सो दैट माई स्टूडेंट्स विल बी एबल टू डू द रिस्पॉन्सेस, फाइल द रिस्पॉन्सेस, सेंट मेल, सेंट मेल, सेंट मेल, स्टार्ट Start, start, start. BBAFM. Fill out the form. My form is open. Control C. You can go through the chat box over there. You will able to find. Sir, आज बहुत लंबा कर दिए लेक्चर. Yes, हो गया थोड़ा ज्यादा. You can file your attendance, and once the attendance has been filed, then you may leave the class. And wish you a very happy Janmashtami to all of you. Enjoy those days to the fullest, and do not forget that we have the examination as well, starting from, I guess, next week, next to next week. Some notifications you will receive from the program coordinator. Some changes have been there in mid-sem examination schedule. And before that, again, we are going to get two to three more classes. Meanwhile, I will share the material as well. I have already shared the practical question material for the PVFV and the bond valuation. But again, I would share some reference material where you can read the definitions, some conceptual understanding you can take regarding the bond and all the things we have done. So that I'm going to share with all of you. Enjoy your day to the fullest. Do not forget that Corona is still there. So, थोड़ा सा ध्यान रखना, इतना ज्यादा भी केयरलेसली बिहेव मत करना, मजे करो, एंजॉय करो. सायोनारा, हम है राही प्यार के, फिर मिलेंगे चलते चलते. फाइल योर अटेंडेंस बिफोर लिविंग द क्लास.